thousandth and tenth day of the human totem pole. The morning was distempered gray of the thousandth and tenth day of the human totem pole. The man at the bottom was smiling. He had just finished his breakfast smiling. It hadn't rained or manured for over 2 hours. The man at the top was starved. The pole was a horrible looking thing, with all those eyes and ears and waving hands for balance. There was no way to get a copter in close, so everybody was starving together. The man at the top had long ago given up, but didn't have nerve enough to climb down. At night, the pole would talk to itself, and the chatter wasn't too good. Obviously, the pole didn't like itself. It wanted to walk. It was the summer, and it was hot, and balance wouldn't permit a skinning to undergarments. It was an integrated pole. It was taking on a reddish-brown cast. Exercise on the pole was isometric, kind of a flex, then balance, then the eyes would roll together, the ears wiggle, hands balance. There was a gurgling and googling heard a tenth of the way up the pole. Approaching was a small child with Statue of Liberty doll.